Hey guys, I'm Studevaos, as always.
Oh, thought you switched persona.
Yeah, I'm thinking of switching every day, but no, I'm actually not schizophrenic, so...
Today I'm Duke Soccer.
Ooh!
Yes.
I use a cousin of Duke Nukem.
Oh, he's just a copycat.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think that's true, but I take your word for it.
I mean, he's not even half as awesome as I am.
You need proof. I'm sorry. Like playing against a nightmare.
Yeah, just look it up. Hey.
So yeah, this is Deepest Evil. Like little 6 map wide, with a little change in kind of fancy stuff. Like for instance, right there we have new armor charge, like a new ammo, like bullet drop.
Yeah,
new
fist
boxes. Animation. And something you might not notice right away is that your movement speed is slower.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's mean.
Actually, it makes something a bit more interesting because it's a bit harder to dodge stuff.
I guess. Games might be like dangerous now.
Yeah. That makes actually enemies more dangerous, and some of them have been graded. There's some bestiary enemies from like bestiary enemies we've seen everywhere, like TNT and Dynamics. There's a few of them.
Alright.
And a little more upgrade. Overall, it's a good stuff, so we'll be seeing the 6 maps.
Alright, 6 maps.
Yeah, for now it's only 6 maps, but the author, which I'm not going to say his name, because... Actually, I'm going to say it is called Shades Master.
Yeah, said. Oh yeah, Shades Master.
He said he's going to make more of the more like episodes, so that's like the first episode thing.
Ah.
And it's actually decent, it's not too fancy, and there's good gameplay, so that's all I like.
So, I've been wondering about this green gas everywhere.
Oh, yeah, green fog everywhere. I don't know.
Did you do that?
No. Nope. Doomguy did.
Doomguy.
Yeah.
When we ever learn to eat some fibers.
Actually, making a sound on this map, I'm not sure. No, I don't think those are maps as this fog, but this one is like a processing facility, whatever, and there's goo, green goo, so it makes sense to have green fog.
I guess.
But I agree, that's kind of annoying.
It's a very green level, though. Green keys and green doors. And
green green door. Don't worry, there's not 6 door keys, just like in. What's his name?
Sapphire. Sapphire.
Remember that.
I was thinking of Needip in... Oh, shit, new enemy.
Yeah, and this one's actually a bit annoying. I'm not fighting him in the goo because, no. Goo.
Yeah.
Usually I just rush into the, like, the secret behind, but I just wanted to not do that so we could at least see him a bit.
Yeah, see him. That's what we're doing right now.
Yeah. Oh, that's 2 more, don't worry.
Good.
So that's a new power-up, gives 50 health. So that's kind of a theme in this. There's a lot of power-ups that are like mid power-up between like low power-up and high power-up. Like,
okay.
Yeah.
So that's a Hades Sphere.
Hades Sphere,
Maybe it's called Hades Master too?
Or Shades.
Yeah.
Like,
there was a joke that it was kind of like Shades.
Yeah, but no. No. Don't try this. This is not the dynamics.
I'm bringing my bad jokes wherever I go.
Damn.
You should have known that when you invited me to this commentary.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. So, as again, there's a like slight two right. This is kind of a Schengen replacement we have here. It's a bit less good, so you're still going to use a shotgun a bunch because it's pretty much the same power.
Okay.
So use both type of ammo all the time. So it'll be another replacement for like Bear Schengen, but you see it right at the end, which is pretty sad.
Oh. It doesn't seem to do any more damage than the normal Schengen.
Yeah, it's kind of the same. I think it's a bit less. Or maybe it's just less accurate, because I know I can't really snipe with that.
Yeah.
No need for sniping anywhere in this, because the maps are... Like, they're no long range fighting.
No.
I can like the design. Well, it's not bad, yeah?
Long range fighting sucks in Doom anyway.
Yeah. Much. We have to snipe or shoot rockets with 10 arrows, guys will snipe some
arrows. Yeah, and then there's hit scan, shotgunners and chain gunners, and then you have to hide behind a corner or get ripped apart in seconds.
Yep.
That's a big door.
Yeah, that's a big door we need to open. And one thing about these maps, though, they use 3D floors.
Ooh.
So like,
you can be, yeah. You can explain it.
So 3D floors, like in Doom, the engine is only not really 3D, it's 2.5D. That means you can't have things on top of each other. Like if you play normal Doom, you see you can't walk on an enemy, even if you're like one story up and trying to jump down on him or something. You can't. You'd be blocked by invisible wall because that's 2.5D.
Yeah, and usually walls solve this by having teleporters, so it seemed that you walked on top of another room.
Oh yeah, that's some Doom maps does do that. Yeah.
Yeah. You play co-op and then you telefrag each other when you walk up the stairs. It's great.
That's your TNT for you. Yes. TNT is like a stair. It looks like you go like one story up, but you just teleport into the rear. And that's very obvious when you look at the map or pressing tab.
But here they actually do it the proper way.
Yeah,
with some fancy new Doom engine stuff.
Actually, yeah, you need OpenGL to have 3D floors. So if you're using Z-Doom or can't like run OpenGL for some reason, ask me why. Or if you're like a true hardcore man and want to use software because it looks, you know, more Doomish, you won't be able to play this.
Yeah.
So here. I keep interrupting you, I'm sorry, but just to explain really quick this M Night, the shot are faster, that's it.
Oh. I was just informing the viewer that they have to make sure that they have an OpenGL-capable computer if they want to play this map. You know, 3DFX cards and all that.
Oh yeah, 3DFX.
Do I have the latest Voodoo 2 card?
I don't know, Voodoo 3, I'm awesome.
Oh goddammit.
Oh, and this guy had the same like gun weapon we had. No. It's the same skin as the fast-firing guy from AT&T or KDPZ, except it's actually more tougher because of this machine gun thing we have.
Copy-pasted.
I mean, it's a slight change, but it replaced chain gunners without being too annoying.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm all for that.
So that's the second map now. And we don't have green fog anymore.
No, we have blue fog.
Yes.
Because the electronic walls like spread into the air.
Yeah, I didn't realize that, but there might be fog in every map.
Maybe with red fog or violet fog or maroon fog or vermilion fog soon.
I'm not sure we get red fog. Maybe the last map, I'm sure.
So I'm guessing you get a blue key this time?
Actually, you're right. There's a red one, I think. God damn it.
See, I can be a map maker too.
Oh, one of the thing, like, you've seen it in a few times, but I picked up, like, a shotgun, like, picker that gives 10 shares and. Like, not 20, but 10. It's like a mix between the 4 shares and the 21.
Shotgun seems to be a bit worse now, too.
No, it's the same.
Okay, because you didn't kill the Sims.
Oh, and just.
And it just seemed like there was less shells hitting them too.
I don't know, it's
like
exactly
when you're firing here. Okay.
I mean, it feels exactly the same, and imps, you know, sometimes I don't die for full shooting shot in the face, so.
Yeah, I know, but I'm used to like saying 5 or whatever those bullet holes when you hit. I only saw like 4, so. But it was just the fog and the graphics, I guess.
It might be a change I didn't notice. It's possible, I'm not sure.
Yeah, whatever.
It's a very slight change, so yeah. And we picked a new power-up, and I have no clue what this one is for. It makes you run a bit faster, and you see
also makes the fog yellow.
Yeah, you see it a bit more, and that's it. So since this is an OpenGL-like map, you have the ability to jump. So here we could get this right away, but I keep it for later. Yeah, Brookhard, you are right.
Yes.
Oh, one thing about 2D5 stuff, like in normal Doom, you can't run over enemies. But in this, even if you play normal maps, you can run over enemies, you can jump over them and stuff like that.
Yep.
The thing you can't do if you're in software is make sectors top each other. Like here, we can see that, it's like the example right there, the sectors on top of each other. And you have enemies there and you can be under them.
Yep.
And have, yeah, 2 floors, something. Yeah. I actually don't know if you can make more than 2 floors. I've seen 3 floors I have no idea. I'm pretty sure you can, but never seen.
Yeah, probably. Why would you limit it to two? It just seems like a strange programming shortcut.
Yeah, I know, but...
Yeah, it seems to be harder to limit it to two floors than, you know, make it fully 3D.
Actually, no. I don't know if it's act on the engine or if it's actually made so you can make 3D stuff. And there
I have no idea, sir.
You should try just making a map image of three floors like that.
Oh, hey, he died differently.
Yeah, okay, Revenants got changed, and even a different animation, and the attack is different. They shoot like two little rockets, like every time before, but they're much faster, but they turn much less. Because only the stupid scenario that the rockets chase you for 10 hours.
Doesn't seem to do as much damage either.
Yeah, they do much less. And Archonauts got changed, they're much more faster. Like, they walk fast! Look at that! It closed me on 2 seconds. Normally, he wouldn't have left his spawn area. Normal Doom.
Yeah. Second.
Oh, and Kaiko, I didn't notice, but they are a different attack.
Yeah, I should blue balls now.
It's slightly homing. So you can't just dodge Alpha Centimeter away and dodge it. You have to put a bit more effort into that.
Spread Arachnotrons.
Yeah, we got this guy from the Bestiary. And as the normal Arachnotrons, they walk fast. The attack is a bit better than the normal Bestiary one. Except it's faster. I mean, I like this guy, though. Too annoying. Fun to fight.
Yeah. I like the idea with making them faster so they move up on you.
Yeah, yeah, and you have to go back or just... Yeah, you can't just stay where you are.
It's a normal... I mean, it's so easy to just hide behind corners and pop out a bit in Doom.
Yes. And the fact you move slower too...
Yeah.
After that. Yeah, and the Revenant change, I'm really happy about that because that's actually a map... Well, I don't mean map... what you could say. I cannot like that in Revenant. It's so much less annoying. It's just like a quick dodge on the side, and you pretty much know that it's done. You won't have to dodge this rocket for 10 hours. And the way the maps are done too. It's smaller corridors, so they just hit a wall anyway. Yeah, Gecko, as you can see, I have to dodge a bit. You have to dodge this shot. It's not really obvious, but they really move just a bit on the side.
Yeah. I'm kinda sick of that, what's it called again? Night vision mode thingy in GZ Doom. I mean, it looked cool at the start, you know, with everything turns green and you can see in the dark. Night vision.
Yeah, night vision, yeah.
Yeah, I'm sick of that effect now.
Oh, yeah, but hopefully it didn't last for long, I won't see it again.
Yeah, it's good.
It was pretty useful in normal Doom, because at the time, you would really not see shit.
Yeah, definitely. But then they just made you see in darkness, not made everything green too. Uh oh. It's the Termi Baron.
Have a Cybrazer. And it's actually not very dangerous, in my opinion. Even if you move it slower, it's not too bad to have the shot, and it does like very, very little IO damage. Like it's extremely small. So either it's the explosion is right next to you, you take like 10 damage, like this. I took like nothing right there. Like 2 health. Yeah. And few armor. So yeah, it's not really a threat, but if you actually bad at dodging stuff and you get shot in the face, you might get hurt. And this is a 3D frog, yeah.
Magic. Oh,
one more of this partial upgrades. You have 150 armor here.
Used to red armor's been like 300.
Oh yeah, that's in some of the mods. I mean, maybe Skirta has it? Not sure.
Maybe?
Maybe it's an addition in Skirta, get like invasion.
Yeah, probably.
I probably that. But yeah, it's a partial upgrade. I mean, you can do fine tunings of ammo and armor on your maps with that. And, yeah, it's not really needed, but why not? Okay, but this is what the mod is about, little changes and slight gameplay changes. And,
Make it a bit new, but still the same.
Yeah. Oh, it's kind of refreshing.
Yeah.
Just like playing normal Doom. It feels like Doom 1 a bit smart, a bit small. Sometimes, like, huge open areas and like some Doom 2 maps.
Oh hey, there's yellow fog. Not red, you lied to me.
I said red was maybe the last map.
Oh.
With the film map now. Is it actually yellow fog or just textures?
I think there's some fog.
Yeah, there's probably some fog.
Yeah, there is.
Yeah, there's fog. And we have a silver key card to get.
Oh. Well, this is not silver fog, or is it?
I can't really tell. It looks like blue fog to me. Okay, one complaint about this, it's easy. Like, even with the slow, like, speed movement, the only time I have any trouble in the, on the maps is at, right at the end. You see what? Oh. You see why. But, everything else is very easy. Because you have a bunch of power-ups, like here, I already have too much health and I get this. Like, oh, I have 200 health. Oh.
Oh, yeah, go over 202.
And a new weapon. Well, I'll be using this a bunch, so don't worry about it. So yeah, the Hadesphere can put you over like 200 health, but only it. If you pick a Soul Sphere, it won't work.
Oh.
So this weapon gimmick, it pierces enemies.
Ah, that's useful.
On its own, it doesn't do much more damage than bullets, but since it can pierce enemies, yeah.
Yeah.
In the right situation, it's an excellent weapon. So it is what made a good weapon. It's not good in every case, so you won't use it as a case, as a not.
Yeah.
I know, it makes sense. And not really too much occasion to hear, just killing a few games, but later on there'll be a few parts where oh hey, I'm pursing like three revenants and fluke demons at the same time, it's great.
Oh yeah. That's beautiful.
She's like most excellent.
Most definitely.
Yeah, there's some games with weapons just, you know, you get a weapon and then you use only that because it's better than everything else.
Yeah.
Here you just use every weapon. There's not enough variety though. I wish I would have like a weak rocket launcher weapon. Something like that.
Hmm. Yeah, I guess.
But yeah, that will do. I mean, it's supposed to have more stuff in the world. How'd there be more stuff? But this is actually good.
Hmm?
Not too long, not too tedious.
Seems hard to use
at the same time.
Good
yeah.
Morning.
Yeah, like it was like a mini cyber demon fight, except no.
It didn't take yeah, too except long. Hmm? He didn't blow you up because he was too close to the wall.
Yeah. Yeah, again, that's my complaint being a bit too easy. Like, the revenants, even if they hit you both rockets, you don't take much damage. Like, here, whoop, I got shot. Well, damn, yeah, still to almost 100 health.
Maybe we should tune up the damage a bit more.
Yeah, I mean, the side bruisers must have a bit more arrow damage, I guess. And stuff like that.
Yeah.
Maybe give you a little bit less box because, yeah, I'm maxed on everything right now, it's not really changing.
Yeah.
But it's a good experience. Nevertheless.
Hahaha.
Excellent. So one thing that makes maps feel a bit like Doom 1 is because they don't use new music. Like new orchestral music, like in Genji, like very loud music and all my videos.
Yeah. So is this a Doom 1 WOD or is it a Doom 2 one?
No, it's Doom 2. I think it just copied badge and midis from Doom 1 the files.
Okay.
Yeah, most mods use Doom 2 anyway.
Yeah, I know that.
That skin has a convention.
Yep.
Yeah, pretty much everything uses Doom 2 except maybe mods that try to make new episode 1 or something like that. There's a few of them, which are actually usually decent, except Clean Ibsendum. I was kidding. It's good, but it's annoying.
Yeah, it's annoying to play.
Map 1, it's 12 minutes.
Takes way too long.
That's fine with Clean-Up Zendoom, but like playing them, making like 100% is takes time.
Yep.
Takes a long amount of time. I like the super secret map, like maybe a spoiler, but I don't care. Like if you finish all the maps, I think I'm not exactly sure it works, but if all the maps quick enough, you unlock the super secret map like Z1M10.
Hmm.
And it's basically a mix-up of a bunch of Doom 1 maps, and it's very long, but it's pretty fun, but it's extremely long, and it never finishes.
Okay, I haven't played that one.
It's pretty good, like, you see, like, especially the example of like Reform 2, you see a lot of layouts for a lot of monomaps, you recognize and pretty good. But it's too long.
Yeah, and Easy Pensandum is good if you want to play like a new game, but if you just want to play a world and have some fun, it's a bit too long.
I guess it's no Eternal. I don't know if you played Eternal, but it's a king of long and complicated and like maze maps.
Okay, I don't think I'll play that then.
Yeah, Eternal is really cool. It's new textures, and it's classic WoW, so it doesn't have like new weapon and stuff. But it still used the AK to make a pretty cool ambience. Music is nice, and there's different team of medieval futurists and time travel and stuff. But all the maps are pretty long, mazy, and you should get keys and backtrack a lot.
Okay. So yeah. That did some damage at least.
Yeah, and the Baron is actually more threatening here because he's bigger. He's like, he has a bigger size, so you're like, oh, this Baron, damn. And you don't have much space to dodge because you're slower and he takes a lot of space by himself. So again, that's a slight change that feels kinda right.
Oh, he's using the score music for a map.
Yep.
How silly.
And I think I didn't lie for a red flag, this one, but like that red flag.
I know, the walls are red. We need to see a bit longer to make sure here.
Oh, new enemy!
Oh, what?
These guys.
They died fast.
They're a replacement for Lost Souls, I guess. There's a new
set
of Lost Souls. And they creep me the fuck out.
Look at they look a bit.
There's one behind the wall. Come on. Look at these things.
The fuck?
No! And we get plasma replacement weapons. So basically, I'm on that control.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's like a plasma game except less powerful, so you still use other weapons. And not only that. So I got a slight change, but yeah. I control you. Ah no, funny.
Oh. Yeah, it's the very same weapon.
I wish I was like another plasma weapon, but I guess this one will do.
No, there's no BFG 5K or something.
No, that's actually a super weapon. We don't find it in these maps. And I looked.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure there's none, but I'm going to like show it right at the end because it's pretty damn good.
Yeah, it probably added a later map.
I mean, it's not damn good. It's
more.
Imbalanced.
Oh.
Like you can kill like a Spider-Man with 3 shots.
Oh.
Yeah, you see what I mean, if you actually show it. I'm pretty sure I'll show it, but... Wrong. Oh, wait.
I think it's brown fog, actually.
Yeah?
Maybe. Or maybe it's just the brown walls. And it's hard to tell on this map.
Yeah, I guess, because everything is brown. It's like I'm playing Quake again.
Yeah.
A bit of red.
Yeah, the floor is all... intestine.
Yeah, so the ceiling is intestine, the ground is like... There's a bit of detail, like you see the ground, there's like still holes and stuff. Just like, those are rooms, not this one. The slight details like that are good. These maps are not over detailed, which is good. That's why it looks a bit like Doom 1, I guess.
Yeah.
And when it's over detailed, like, you know, knee deep is that Doom? Or like, Ultimate Online Torture is a bit over detailed too. But I guess it has a nice overlook.
Yeah.
Not too big of a deal. But yeah, sometimes...
You don't really need that in Doom.
Yeah, no, if you want to make... kind of classic-ish Doom maps, you don't want too much details. And it's just a map if you don't want too much details. You can make some pretty stuff without having 10,000 details. Slobs and whatever. Oh, by the way, I get all secrets on every map, but... I'm sure you noticed by now.
Secrets.
I actually got all items on almost every map except one because I didn't pick up some virus because I was like over 200 health for that virus.
Yeah, that's just annoying.
Oh, something happens in the maps, in like this map a bit. Like you have doors linked to enemies. Like when I kill this guy, open this door and so on.
Okay.
I guess it's a bit like E1 and 8.
Yeah.
And here, open the window door. the bow back and I can open the one. And these guys, they may seem threatening because they're fast and stuff, but they're much less as than those souls.
Yeah, I noticed that the first time you shot him with one shotgun blast and he died.
Yeah, you might be scared of a card when you see them like crawling on the but don't worry, just keep shooting. They die. Okay, what I'm doing? Yes. Get these shards.
It's important.
Yeah. Actually, the shards give you 2 armor on that one.
Ooh.
It's like a slight change, which is kinda good. The virus, you give 1. Yeah. Your health is much more easy to come by, so.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, I did a little here, so a little hole on the ceiling with a little lava, I mean, it looks decent, so without being too dumb. And then rocket launcher without any splash damage for you.
Oh.
Again, this next thing a bit too easy.
But you can't rocket jump anymore?
No. I mean, that might be a defense against rocket jump too, I guess, yeah. But I suppose that would make sense to have splash damage for your own rocket launcher, since the map is like clustered like this.
Yeah, I guess.
You're going down to rocket launcher on this map, so you can kill yourself.
Yeah.
Nope. Oh, you damn sniper. Too easy to cheese up.
Yeah, they are kinda mini cyber demons. Shooting 3 times and stuff.
Yeah, so they act just like a cyber demon, but, you know, they're easier to kill and they don't rape your face.
Yeah.
What I'm doing? Yeah, I'm pointing this door we have to open and I... What I'm doing? Where I'm going? Oh, I'm going back to get this armor now, I think. Yeah, these secrets, because I didn't pick them up. Because I didn't need them at the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You were below 100 armor there. Good thing you got it.
Yeah, damn. I could have died. Actually, this side... Oh, forgot this guy. This guy is actually tough. You know this guy from, like, a bunch of... Like
yeah,
and stuff. But he actually has different attacks, like he shots a lot more.
Whoa.
And if actually dodge somehow by crouching. I'm allowing to crouch because this is really like thing. Like, oh, I'm crouching because it's really.
Yep.
But crouching to dodge run with normal doom is a bit cheating, I guess.
Yeah, this a guy, bit.
Yeah, a bit. So this guy, if he actually shoots you in the face, you die in like 3 hits. Here, 4 hits, I'm dead. Pretty much. With all this ammo and stuff. Hey, I don't know why he did that. Oh, hey, exit, elevator, like, oh no, it's a trap! And then it's not a trap.
Ah, he fooled you. Oh wait, it's hangar again.
Yeah, and like the first map, it looks like hangar too. I don't know why. And why not? It works. It's a layout which works.
Yeah.
And this stuff's actually tougher than you think. Just, there's not really much bunch of enemies, but actually... You can actually die here. You know, like, if you got like very wounded by the guy before.
Yeah, I guess. Can't really kill him instantly because you have some health and.
Yeah.
Your guns aren't all powerful.
Yeah, you don't have optimal guns. You can't just take the plasma gun and wipe the thing because, yeah, this plasma gun's not that good.
Yeah.
It's decent, but just like everything I have. So here we start to have a bit more enemies, but it's not going to get them as like an Equinox. Still like not really tough.
Oh, there's no giant area where there's 500 cyber demons and stuff?
Yeah.
No. Oh.
Fuck this. You actually like sometimes like stupid maps like in like Alien Vendetta, Aerovid or Scythe or those are kind of classic map packs. Because you actually have a BFG, a rocket launcher, and you can kill them pretty easily, but in Equinox...
Yeah.
I don't see you kill that much cyber demons. It's really fun. Especially with psychic weapons, not really used to kill a big bunch of enemies.
Yeah.
Very good for like tough fights and stuff like that. Not for big...
Ooh, a double chainsaw, of course.
It's actually a double chainsaw, just skin, I think. I don't use it anyway, why is not chainsaw here? And all these guns and all this ammo. One thing that makes me very sad is no berserk.
Aww. It probably used to be a mini berserk that makes you a bit angry. And the screen a bit red. And you deal a bit more damage.
I guess. And this gecko's came from the ceiling, which actually we can touch.
I'm gonna rip off your toe! Oh no.
Oh god.
You have medium-sized guts.
Medium-sized guts. Yeah, I guess that makes sense, yeah. Everything is medium-sized. It's a medium-sized thing.
Yes.
It's not like Claustrophobia, like Claustrophobia maps, you know, like... I've never seen this, but they're like, there's two sets, it was like, kind of a contest, I think, not really. The maps are like 1024... sectors? No, not sectors, what's the units? I forgot what it is, but... Our maps are like 1024 by 1024.
Yeah.
Which is pretty small. And there's like two hours of this, and they're pretty cool.
Yeah, play that, I think. Not through hole, but it's pretty cool.
Yeah, pretty cool. So, I mean, it's a good conversion. The maps are not too long, but still not tedious because you have enemies you can have enemies in scenery outside the area. And so, like, there's a few maps with like 300 enemies in this section.
Yeah, I think I know one of those maps you're talking about.
Oh, most of the time you have maps when enemies spawn, got teleported in the area, so...
Yep.
It takes long time, or it shouldn't take long.
I stopped playing on one of those levels because I just got bored.
Yeah, it's not one that you just have, like not much enemies, or a bit tough fight, like, oh, fight a baron in a close space, stuff like that. But not when you have enemies teleporting over and over again.
Yep.
I don't like that.
Me neither.
There's a bunch of maps that do this, you see, like, oh, there's only 100 monsters, and yeah, you kill like, and at the end you kill like 600 because I appear, I script the map.
Hey, there's like no fog on this map. Just a bit.
Yeah, there's still fog a bit.
Well, not much though.
There's fog. There's always fog. Must be fog. Medium-sized fog.
Well, fog has been the only thing that's been extreme on these maps so far, but.
I guess, yeah. It has to fit with a medium-sized box of ammo, medium-sized armor, medium-sized health upgrade, medium-sized weapons.
That Baron is extra-sized though.
Yeah, it's like a Big Mac. and his head a bit go through the ceiling. That shows how real it was, yeah. Goes through the ceiling and it looks a bit silly.
I think monsters should take damage when they bang right against the ceiling like that.
Boom, bang! And get stunned. No.
Yeah, then you laugh at them.
A bit hard to implement. Oh. Yeah. I know, Revenants can in fight. So, I don't know if you could see them for a second, but they can fight. Now.
Yeah, I missed that, but. That's cool.
I imagine if that was going to happen in like this big map with like 500 Revenants.
And yeah, it might actually not be a pain in the ass anymore.
Yeah. Oh yeah, like the Baron and then I shot up faster, it's kind of hard to dodge, but when you get used to it, it's fine, but... You know, especially that, since you're slower and you don't have much room to dodge, makes actually more tricky.
Yeah, and you're so used to dodging them normally, so...
Yeah.
At the start, I guess, you just get hit a lot.
Yeah, you just need to get used to it, it's not too terrible.
Yeah.
Oh, you also have a super shotgun too, so yeah.
Yeah.
So that's the last map already. And I thought it was this one that was red fog, but didn't have red fog.
No, it's just normal fog.
Yeah.
And burning torches that has sound.
I cannot know sound. You hear it all over maps, though.
Oh.
So for this map, we have to find keys and open like a teleporter thingy, and then we're done, except this one thing. Yeah.
Wait. Keys? You're gonna have to explain yourself now.
You know, there's these three keys, red, yellow, and blue. You have to get them, and you go to a door, and you press use, and they open, it's magic.
Wait, I'm writing this down. What colors were there again?
Blue, yellow, and green? Oh, no, fuck! It's red.
Blue, no, yellow!
I would be funny if you had the wrong key and open a door, it would kill you.
Yeah. Very Monty Python.
I mean, you could make a joke out of that, but that wouldn't be funny.
I will make it after this video.
Don't.
I shall name it Sand Dynamics 2.
So Return of Sand Dynamics.
Oh, Return of Equinox.
And then the only enemy you put in that is, what's the name already? This allows souls that suicide on your face. We forgot what they sound like. Like, there's a jump at you and just boom and you die on it.
I'm gonna give them the Serious Sam screaming guy sound too.
Oh, we're so dumb.
Oh yeah, this also reminds me of a certain Doom map.
Yeah, when I played that, I thought about mentioning it, but since we're saying shit instead. But yeah, alright. I forgot which one it is, but it's a Doom 2 map, exactly the same situation. I like this, it's a good use of teleports. Not teleporting on your face constantly. Just, I think situations to teleport right behind you and like, oh no, I have to go behind, the enemy's on the side too. Damn.
Ambush!
Yeah. So, one thing too good about this, you don't use teleports much. Like, almost no teleports with some enemies at all. It's very good. I like there's no teleporting enemies everywhere.
Yeah.
So it gets way out of hand. And no, there's not much monster closets too. There's just a bit. A few. But it's not too bad. It's not like, Plutonia or TNT or, get a key and then bam, there's 10 monster closets open on the map and...
Even normal Doom and Doom 2 did that.
Yeah, true, yeah.
Go down a long corridor, pick up some shotgun and ooh, a Baron spawned behind you! Ooh. And you can't dodge!
Yeah, pretty much. The most known is like in E1 and 3, the key, like, oh, I'm stuck! And at the time you could really not see shit, because you were playing the software.
Ooh,
so, now we got a new chain gun. It's like Skirt Attack chain gun a bit.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, frame very fast, you have the cooldown time. So yeah, we're fighting this guy almost take no pain, and ow!
Ouch.
I got hurt once.
Yeah.
Once. And sometimes when you start shooting, it just never stops. Fuck this guy.
I think he's dead, Bob.
Okay, here I'm going to do something dumb. I'm press a switch, get the health, and then door close. Oh, good job.
My feet!
Yes. We got all the keys now. So we can... we're almost done with this already, damn.
Ooh. Magic.
Oh, you see this thing in the center is actually not done a few block shots like it does in normal Doom. And I got shot in the face a few times because of that.
I'm gonna hide behind this, yeah.
And bang in the face.
Fool you.
Now we can go here. And actually, it's here. And oh, what's that? Actually, no. It's not a pain elementals.
No, it's a... plasma elemental.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know this guy here. You just two of them is like, isn't that boring? It's exactly the same as Keiko's. Slightly aiming missiles, just different... sprites and... attacks. Words. Yeah. That's really interesting.
Ooh.
And we got the shotgun back, except we won't be reusing it.
Yeah, and you got like 2 minutes left or something.
Yep. A bit of cheese. Alright, so now is the only problem I have with this map. This guy.
Oh, that guy.
This is a Terminator.
Remember him from the Renegade mod.
Oh yeah. Yeah, it's not actually a mech in a Renegade mod. It's an enemy with... It's like, this guy is more powerful than a Cyber Demon. He has much different types.
Ouch.
Like this. He has a chain gun, he has homing bolts, and he has one other, I forgot. Yeah, this thing. Whoop! I will explosion. Yeah, and like three succession of explosions, like seven.
It's pretty cool that he has such many different weapons.
Yeah, that's what it means, actually, cool, because you have lots of different weapons, so you have to account for all of them. Like, if he's going to use a chain gun, you have to go behind a wall. If he's homing missile, you have to lure it away. And if you use a bouncing thing, you really have to get out of the way and different ways.
Yeah.
Actually, this is actually a funny fight on the hard. Like here, I'm doing much more than everywhere in the mod. And he's almost immune to pain too, so like, yeah, shooting him with the chain doesn't really work.
You should try the chainsaw.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Why didn't you think of that?
Ow, ow, ow. Inches. He actually killed me once, but that's not in this recording. It was on, like,
on that telefrag him.
Yeah, I was thinking of that, but now he already moved out of the way. And I would die anyway.
Yeah.
I'm pretty cornered here. Like, oops, this is bad. Oh, and he died. Victory. Yes.
Are you lucky you didn't do this grenade thing?
Yeah. Oh god, yeah. So we're done, that's it, is it already? But I think I'm going to show up show weapon pretty quick, am I? Actually, no, I don't think I'm going to show weapon, I'm going to do this. Just for 100% enemy skilled. Right, I almost died for that. So actually, there's one weapon which is kind of a staff thing, which is a bit too powerful. But I'm going to show it because you don't get it anyway. And you just let's, like, bounce around and kill stuff very fast. So that was Deeper Civil.
Yeah, that was a nice one.
Yeah, nice classic mix-up, what, between stuff. So I hope you enjoyed it.
Yes.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.